は15歳の時、自分の道を決めました。僕は夢を叶えるためにこの表を作りました。
Hey, baseball fans, this is Chris Singleton, and welcome to MLB the Show.
I'm the center of attention, the main attraction. When I enter the turf, when I pull up,
what happened?
People gather around me like an ice cream truck.
No cap.
People always ask me what I do for a living.
What you do?
I wear many hats. I'm something like Liz.
I love
Liz.
Big soap. Big soap. Whooper in the bag like what's
she got her.
For the second time in 3 years, the World Series trophy resides in the NL East, as the Braves broke through and claimed their first title since 1995. 3 games under .500 on August 1st, Atlanta went 36-18 down the stretch and dominated the postseason. If they hope to repeat, they'll have to fend off a trio of challengers that all expect to take a big step forward in 2022. The Phillies believe that they have the top-to-bottom talent to unseat the champs. The same goes for a reloaded Mets squad that was in first place as late as mid-August before fading late. The Marlins have a dynamic rotation that will make life uncomfortable for the rest of the division. Only the Nationals, 2 years removed from their own title, seem unlikely to threaten the Braves, instead playing equal parts spoiler and cautionary tale of how fleeting the ultimate success can be.
Up loud and let that bump. Everybody love the funk. Slumping in the trunk. You in the back seat, wishing you was in the front. She said something, asking if I heard. I can't hear one word.
Big subwoofer in the back, like what's up? Blow the windows out of frame. It's a party when I pull up. Big subwoofer in the back, like what's up? Blow the windows out of frame. It's a party when I pull up. Big subwoofer in the back, like what's up? Blow the windows out of frame. It's a party when I pull up.
Oh, the land of the free and the home of the brave.
The crowd is amped up, ready to get this season underway, as are we. Back with more in a minute. Here in Miami, Lone Depot Park, opening day 2022 on MLB The Show. The Atlanta Braves taking on the Miami Marlins.
Yeah.
here at the ballpark. Here's the catcher, Travis Darnot.
Leading off for Atlanta, the catcher, Travis Darnot.
This one high in the air to left center. Sanchez on the move to his right. Snags it on the run. One away.
Now that, designated hit.
That was a great run to make the catch, Singy. We got to take another look at it with StatCast.
Yeah, he saw it perfectly off the bat. The actions were excellent. Took a very direct route to the ball, and more than 100 feet later, he ran it down. I just love seeing it.
Here's Dickerson now. Hit left field, base hit. Around first and hustling for second. And he pulls in with a double for his first hit of the year.
These guys today are so great with handling velocity. They're seeing high speeds day after day, and a nice job of turning that one around.
Dansby Swanson stands in. That's hard hit in the line. Can't get there, base hit. Runner around third. And he's safe at the plate as they take the lead. 1-0.
Went up there looking to be aggressive and got something he could handle. That's a good sound coming off the bat, man. And as he connected out front and ripped it into the outfield, that's one of those swings where you just don't even feel the ball hit the barrel. That's a pure stroke.
Here's Eddie Rosario. Into third now, so runners at the corners and one out.
Well, that's a smart decision to hold up with one out and the heart of the order coming up. Don't want to run into an out at home plate.
And now it's Matt Olson's turn to hit. Swing and a ball lifted in the air, left field, pretty well struck. One run across, hangs off the wall. Rojas with a relay home. Not in time, he scores. It's 3-0.
First pitch swing in, went up there with the plan to be aggressive. So close to blasting that one out of here the other way, but that's very tough to do when you take on the outfield gap like that. Beautiful swing, though. Let the ball get a little deep and drove it to the opposite field.
Man at second with one away. Austin Riley next up for the Braves. He swings and drives one out to deep left field. And forget it. Austin Riley goes deep. His first homer of the year, and they add a couple more. It's 5-0.
He's so good at getting his arms extended, and that's exactly what he did right there. You don't typically want to pull a pitch in that part of the plate, but he doesn't allow his wrist to roll over, stays through the ball, gets the loft, and gets the home run.
One out, base is empty. Here's Marcelo Zuna, 1-for-2.
Now batting, left fielder.
He swings and misses at the first pitch, 0-1. Still only one out here in the inning. hit to right. And that's a base hit. So a man aboard now with one away.
This is unbelievable. That's now six consecutive hits by this lineup. With the way defenders track down balls these days, I mean, both from the infield and in the outfield, there really aren't a lot of base hits on balls hit like that. But there's always a little room back behind the first and second baseman to drop a lawn dart in there, and he found a way.
Cody Pochi on a pitch out of the pen here. He comes in with his team trailing by a bunch, so he'll try to keep it where it is.
Well, at this point of the ball game, we're talking about middle innings, and we get a little length out of this arm coming out of the bullpen. Just how many outs he's able to give his skipper.
Ozzie Albies up to the plate. This guy has turned into a beast. That one ripped left field. That's back there. And that one's gone. Ozzie Albies goes the opposite way. His first homer of the year, and they throw a pair on the board. It's 7-0. Adam Duvall at the plate.
Now batting, the center fielder, Adam Duvall.
And first offering is fouled off. In the air, right side. Garcia flying after this one. Long run, tracks it down. And there are two down.
Now batting, catcher, Travis.
And Darno. Now it's Travis Darno with the plate. There's a strike.
Looks like he went up there guessing on the first pitch and was going to sell out to it. Didn't make any contact, though.
That's out to center field. Sanchez on his way over. Puts the squeeze on it. That is the inning. The final damage here, they bat around. 10 come to the plate, 7 runs on the board. Top of the order due up in the home half of the sixth. It's the Braves 7. Ready to go for the last half of the inning. Jazz Chisholm now. We talk about guys with good speed. And definitely he has it, but pushing the offense aside for just a second, Chris, it's the defensive side that I think the speed factors in the most.
Well, he gets to balls that get by most people at that position. Just really impressive, because there are certain times the ball comes off the bat, automatically that team that hit it thinks that they've got a base hit, or they may have extra bases, and he just takes it away.
Comes up empty on the swing, 0-2 now. And a foul ball, he stays alive. And a pitch. That's towards center. Duvall makes the grab, and there's one down.
Well, on the mound, very efficient, able to produce an outcome. It seems like within the third or fourth pitch of just about every at bat.
Jorge Soler up at the plate. Swings through that one. 0-1.
And it really looks like these hitters have been in between with their timing today. Good fastball, excellent slider, but they've not been able to commit to one velocity and stay there.
No ball.
0-2 as he waves at that one. Next offering upstairs.
Pretty standard high 0-2 fastball right there. If you're smart, you'll look for something down in the zone, but not too far. Don't want to chase that breaking ball in the dirt.
And a swing and a miss. So he's gotten deep into this game, and at least so far, not showing a ton of signs of fatigue.
The designated hitter, Garrett Cooper. So I ain't saving you a cleaning house. Think that's just a statement, then you ludicrous like it's word of mouth. I ain't new to what I'm about. Excuse me, miss, like what's your name? How about we just tone it down, then go back to where you came from. I ain't gotta prove nothing now. One idea.
Two outs, space is empty, and now it's Garrett Cooper up to him. Swings here and blasts one left field. That's back there. Gone! His first homer of the year, and they cut into the lead. It's 7-1.
So impressive how he was able to go down and get this fastball, but yet get it up in the air, hit it far enough to get out of this ballpark.
So two down, Avisail Garcia up to the plate.
Now batting, the right fielder, Avisail Garcia.
And first offering is fouled off. And now the lefty. Strike two.
I got the count 0-2.
And a swing and a miss. And that's that. One for the Marlins on the solo shot. And the lead is stretched to 7-1. Back here in Miami, top of inning number 7. Now it's Alex Dickerson.
The designated hitter, Alex Dickerson.
Poti back to work. This one popped up. Rojas makes the grab. One pitch and one out.
The batter, number 7. Shortstop, Dansby Swanson.
Dansby Swanson, the next to hit.
Swanson, former first-round pick by the Arizona Diamondbacks. Vanderbilt player in college, College World Series player, all that good stuff, but really coming into his own.
Hit on the ground to the right side. Aguilar takes it himself. Two up, two down.
Now batting, right fielder, Eddie Rosario.
Back to the leadoff spot in the Braves lineup. Eddie Rosario next up for the Braves. Out there to center. Soler makes his way towards it. He can't get there. That should be extra bases. Round second, digging for third. And he's got himself a triple.
Now, no waiting around right there. He was ready now to better. Swing it on the first the pitch. First just a very nice approach now. And swing right there to use the big part of the field. Everything was on time. He stayed balanced through the entire swing and just launched that one into center.
Here is Matt Olson.
Really good piece of hitting last time going to the opposite field.
Here's a high fly ball out to center. Sanchez gets under it. And that is the third out of the inning. Braves strand one. They're on top of 7-1. Welcome back. Bottom of the seventh. And now for the Marlins. Jesus Sanchez.
The center fielder.
The wind of the pitch on the ground, tosses across the first, and a quick out number one.
Up next for the Marlins, the first baseman Jesus Aguilar.
And now it's Jesus Aguilar. On the ground, right side. Over to first. And a couple of quick outs.
Now batting, the third baseman, Ryan Anderson.
Two outs, base is empty. Now the third baseman, Ryan Anderson. First pitch, and that's in for a strike. Two down, nobody on. That clips a corner.
This guy's pounding the zone. Hitters don't have time to think in between pitches.
The 0-2. And ball one.
Two strikes.
Why to kick the pitch. That one close, ruled a ball. And that's ball two. Here comes the pitch. Stays alive. The 2-2. Swing and a miss, and he is down on strikes for the third straight at bat. Nothing doing for the Marlins. They're down 7-1. Back here at Lone Depot Park, ready to begin in the eighth. Now in for the Braves, Austin Riley.
Austin Riley.
And he deals. And That one lifted in the air center field. Racing makes the catch. And there's one away.
Now batting, left fielder, Marcell Ozuna.
And next will be the cleanup hitter, Marcell Ozuna. In there, and it's 0-1. The 0-1. And that one clips the corner.
No ball, two strikes.
At the belt and fires. And a foul ball, he stays alive. And a pitch. On a line, base hit. Around first, heading for two. It's a double, and he's 3-for-4 tonight.
Nice double right there. Loud contact coming off the bat. Didn't get enough air under to drive it out of here, but you'll take that swing and that result every time.
Here is Ozzie Albies up to him. Line drive, base hit. Ozuna coming home. He'll score, and they're pulling away up by 7 now.
Back-to-back base hits. Nice line drive to the pull side, met it out front, 14. But just stayed through it Adam. Nice enough and ripped it into the outfield.
One down. Adam Duvall next up for the Braves.
He's going, he's going, he's going.
To second, and he's out.
Really nice job right there, especially on the mound. Sometimes when that runner breaks, everybody panics, especially the pitcher, and then you don't make the play, you don't execute what needs to be done to get that runner out. That time, he just stepped off calmly, dealt with the situation, and they got a pretty easy out after that.
And that one is lifted in the air. And that is that. Last half of the eighth coming up. It's the Braves 8 and the Marlins 1. On to the bottom of the eighth, and now it's going to be Jacob Stallings. This guy, one of the best defensive catchers going. You talk about framing, the ability to block, catch, and throw. He is at the top of the game. The pitch. That's inside.
Really good athlete, and many times you talk about, you know, the feet of infielders. This catcher as well, really quick feet. He's able to recognize the pitch, see the trajectory, and get into a spot where he can block those balls and keep them from going to the backstop.
Ozuna racing over to make the catch.
Shortstop.
Miguel Rojas at the plate. Swing and a high fly ball out there towards left field. And puts the squeeze on that. And there's two down.
Just pulled off of it a little bit right there. That front shoulder coming open instead of staying closed. If he does that, he's going to be able to go up the middle the other way with some authority instead of a fly out to left.
And stepping in is the speedy Jazz Chisholm. I'm a soldier, straight rock and roll. fought off foul. Next offering is down low. 1-1 now. He swings and fouls one off. And he chases that one. And he's down on strikes for the second time today. And the Marlins down quietly. It's still an 8-1 ball game. I got my blessing because the father never left him. Back here at the ballpark, new inning getting started. And here's the catcher, Travis d'Arnaud.
The catcher, Travis d'Arnaud.
Poti back to work. That one blasted deep to right. That's back. Pulls it in on the warning track.
He was all over that first pitch fastball. Just barely missed it. Man, this guy was ready to hit.
Alex Dickerson.
So now the DH spot, Alex Dickerson. And first offering is fouled off. Right-handed reliever. And a foul ball. Righty delivers. Got him looking. And there are two outs.
Well, that's a pitch, that slider from an opposite-handed pitcher that you usually see very well, but for some reason he didn't pick it up, and it just kind of got into the strike zone late. Gave up on it a little bit early.
Dansby Swanson now at the plate. And he swings and misses, and it's nothing at one. They say it went.
Well, two outs and a chance to put up a zero on the scoreboard here, and that's not something that's come easy for this staff in this one.
Here's the 0-2. Drilled out towards left center field. That's well struck. That's bad. That one is gone. Dansby Swanson hits one out. And they tack one on the board. It's 9-1.
For a pitcher, the odds are in your favor if you keep that breaking ball down. That time, he got punished for it. Hitter just did a really good job of staying within himself and getting the barrel to the baseball.
Richard Blyer comes on now. Big deficit here, but he's still got a job to do.
Richard Blyer.
And now the right fielder, Eddie Rosario.
Now batting, the right fielder. Eddie
Rosario checks his swing. Appeal down to third, and that's going to be ruled a swing. Left-hand batter waits. Strike two. And here it comes. Got it. And that'll do it. Braves get one of the big fly. And they're starting to run away. It's now 9-1. Let me offer my condolences. You don't know just how I'm doing. The silence go to broke because they know him for talking fluent. Got him under the influence. The truest is talking to him. But it's on your ego bumping him out. Music on it. Hey, y'all ain't ready. Hey, the home, y'all city. Bottom 9. And at the plate for Miami, Jorge Soler.
Leading off for the Marlins, the left fielder, Jorge. No.
And a pitch. Ball one, no strikes. Bounce to the left side. Albies sends it to first. And the leadoff man retired here in the ninth.
The batter, the designated hitter, Garrett Cooper.
And next is the designated hitter, Garrett Cooper.
No matter what, you're playing this kind of rival, take your game to another level.
Back to where you came from. I ain't gotta prove nothing now. One idea worth 100,000. So if that's about your budget now, in a room for discussion now. I'm trying to show and improve, ay. Never get stuck in the past. Just ain't nothing I do. Nah, wanna post up with the crew. I bet that she call my bluff, yeah. Hey, you know, baby.
Here comes the skipper, and we're gonna see a pitching change in this spot. Max Fried will give way. We'll be back in a minute with a new arm on the mound.
I gotta get it pronto, yo. Sequence occurring. Mommy meets me, nobre es papi chulo. Mi nombre es papi.
Spencer Strider into the game, and a healthy sized lead for him to go to work with.
Spencer Strider.
And he swings and misses at the initial offering. The wind of the pitch. Swing and a miss as he was late.
I think he was sitting off speed there.
And the 0-2. And that's outside. Right-hander kicks, deals. The punch out there. Two gone.
Just a mid-90s challenge fastball right there. Not much to it. And I'm sure he'd love another swing at it because it was in a very hittable location. Those are the swings where you sometimes start to question yourself as a hitter and say, how did I miss that? But you know what happens.
Two outs, base is empty. And now Abisail Garcia. Swings through that one. 0-1. And the right-hander deals. That catches the corner. And a swing and a miss, and that is the ball game.
Can you hear? Are we clear?
back here in Atlanta. Welcome in John Ciambi and Chris Singleton. We've got one out here in inning number 7. Feeling like a caged bird. I want to spread my wings and fly that freedom. My girl back. One down, runner at first. Now the Atlanta cleanup hitter, Marcell Ozuna.
You're a base runner. You've got to stay dialed in here. Look for anything in the dirt. Try your best to get into scoring position.
Movement in the bullpen. Ryan Hendricks appears to be getting loose. Warren getting loose as well. Kick Sandios. And that one pulled foul.
With two strikes. May see some movement over there at first base. Try to stay out of a double play here.
And the righty deals. And that just misses.
Really good take, especially with two strikes.
Stays alive. Righty to the plate. That's the third. Nice stop. The throw moves. Toss to second. On to first. Save. So they get one, but a really nice try there.
The second baseman, Ozzie Albi.
Ozzie Albi's up to the plate. This guy has turned into a beast. And a foul ball. This to center field. Senzel under it. Makes the catch, inning over. One left for Atlanta. So we're still tied at 6. We're at the top of the 8th. Now the Reds cleanup hitter, Tyler Stevenson.
Leading off for Cincinnati, the catcher, Tyler Stevenson.
Pitch. Nope. That's down and in. And a swing and a miss.
That fastball at the bottom of the zone can be very effective. Just got to keep it on the corners.
And 1-2.
That's a real nice cutter right there. I mean, this guy can struggle with the inside pitch at times, so I'd say that's pretty effective if you can commit it on that side of the plate.
Next offering is downstairs. Fastball, he gets out of the way.
At this point in the game, you cannot issue free passes. He's going to have to challenge this hitter. Hitter's got to be ready to swing it.
That one misses, so a leadoff walk.
Oh, good day for the on-base percentage right there. Walk number 3, and the free bags keep on coming. You down with OBP, Boo?
No outs, runner at first. Here's Mike Moustakas to hit.
I mean, these guys know they have to get going out of the gates, but... you're not going to hear a skipper. You're not going to hear people really say that.
Bound back our way, and that's out of play. and a pitch. And there's something you don't see very much in today's game, the pitch out. Next one is off the plate. Now two balls and a strike. The pitch. And one fouled off, 2-2. Left-hand hitter waits. Swing and a foul back. That's out of play. Here's the 2-2. And a foul ball. He stays alive. Got it. Down on strikes. And he knew it. Frustrating.
Sit on him for a little while. You want to be ready to hit the fastball. Sometimes you can overthink things, and I think that was the case right there.
Here's Tommy Pham for the fourth time tonight.
Definitely wants to stay out of the double play here. Ball.